How goes the family? Welcome back to Larry's Anything Goes. Hope you guys having a great and exceptional day. Well, it's that time of the week, family, where I love to highlight black-owned businesses. I came across this article the other day that really caught my attention, which stated that the newest and only state-licensed cannabis dispensary in San Francisco, Parks Mercer, cousins Eric Grayson, Kenna Middleton, and Charles Tony II, all teamed up to launch a business that could set an example for their community and honor their family all at the same time, which, you know, I love that. Family economics is the cornerstone of a community. And this is so important because one can post thousands upon thousands upon thousands of posts via social media. But if one wants to inspire today and tomorrow's generation of black entrepreneurs, then they have to see it to believe it, family. The article also stated that it means a lot because they are from, you know, the community in San Francisco, but it means a lot more because it took so much effort even to get to this point, to where they are. Flight, which is the name of the dispensary in San Francisco, is not your regular business by any means. You can open up a million other things before you open up one of these dispensaries. This is what the group, these gentlemen stated. They stated it has a lot to do with being black as well as, but to be able to do it with family members means the world. And family, I couldn't agree with that statement more, because being able to make money moves with your family is great, but being able to make, being able to make money moves with your friends is great, but being able to make money with your family is 10 times better. The article also stated that the dispensary's name itself is a tribute to Grayson's mother, Clara Grayson, who passed away from cancer after the family pulled money together to fly her to Europe. Her passing, coupled with Tony's second mother's recent passing, as well as personal health and wellness issues, inspired the three co-founders to help others to realize the healing and relief powers of cannabis. Now, am I a fan of utilizing cannabis? No, not at all. Don't smoke it. Don't do it. Not a big fan of it. But I totally understand those who do. And I have seen the amount of businesses that have been started, you know, within the state of California, Oregon, Washington State, Nevada, and so on. And sometimes, you know, when close family members pass, it totally changes the mindset and perspectives. We've all gone through it, you know, no matter what age you are in this life, we've all gone through losing a family member or a close friend of ours and whatnot. And that's why you got to appreciate the people that you have in this life. And not only that, let them know that you appreciate them. Friends, family, whatever, friends that turn into family, somebody that you love, somebody that you've always been in love with but scared to say it. And I'm getting off subject here, but let people know that they mean a lot to you, because you never know, that might just be like an adrenaline shot or an espresso, a couple of espresso, a cup of coffee, whatnot, to somebody's personality, to somebody's mood, to somebody's mindset, to somebody's life. All right. Anyways, the article also stated that with backgrounds in cannabis, both the medical business and cultivation, all three men meeting the San Francisco Social Equity Program's criteria, which aims to create equal opportunity and secure ownership in the multi-billion dollar cannabis industry. Partnered with Los Angeles-based cannabis holding company, the Shrine Group, to start their business, because in most instances, for one, to get into the cannabis business, they have to have millions upon millions of dollars in assets, not just millions of dollars, but millions of dollars in assets. Flight, as a cannabis dispensary, aims to prove to its community that the store represents both another way to make a living and a pathway to achieving a healthy lifestyle. The article ended on this note, family. Being the only black and family-owned cannabis dispensary, on top of being the only state-licensed store in Park Mercer, the three co-founders hope that their brand will act as a catalyst for change in the cannabis space, not just for the black communities, but also for health and wellness. The direction that they are going in with their company is more towards health and wellness, and they are going to be incorporating nutritional factors that have the same compound benefits as certain fruits and vegetables. Tony II stated that. He stated, a lot of times in the black community, we don't have the proper resources, and sometimes people may end up in prison or in the hospital on a gang of medications that they don't need. This is very true. So they want to teach people that there are other ways around those things that can give them the right help that they need. And I commend these great people for educating the community about this, because the kind of mentorship, this kind of mentorship is essential to the survival of the Black community. And if you want to check these great people out, the business flight is currently open now, and it's located at, and I quote, 61 Cambone Drive, San Francisco, California. Once again, flight, the cannabis dispensary is located at 61 Cambone Drive, San Francisco, California. But anyways, and that's another thing, you know, I say this a lot and I'll continuously say this till the day I die. The pandemic really taught me more so to be take my health way more seriously, and I hope that it taught a lot of other people to take your health way more seriously. Now, it doesn't mean you need to turn to a vegan, doesn't mean you need to be the most in shape person on the planet. I'm not going to say that, but I will say, you know, get a little exercising in, get some fruits and veggies in, you know, maybe drink some, you know, non-sugar tea, and just, you know, find your way to health and wellness on your own. Because for all the people that we've lost before the pandemic, during the pandemic, after the pandemic, unfortunately, a lot of instances was because they took their health for granted. And I implore you all out there, do not take your health for granted, because your health at the end of the day is your wealth. It's the biggest money move you can make on this planet. All right. So I'll leave it at that. If you want to check out Larry's Anything Goes, we sell a variety of products. So just check out our Shopify store link in the comment section. And this is the height in a big fight of the cryptocurrency space. So if you're a crypto investor like myself, think about becoming an affiliate with the Gold Standard Partners. Information's in the description. You have the opportunity to not only buy cryptocurrency, but the opportunity to refer others to do the same thing and be able to make money off of the crypto purchases. Gold Standard Partners has their own crypto coin, which is G999, so check them out. On that note, family, do the great three free things. Like, share, and subscribe. Have a great day. And always remember, you can't get fired if you own the company. We're going into 2022. It's time for you to own something. Take care, family.